So, this is a video for telling stories with clay in our hand, or as I've started to think of it, salt dough Shakespeare. Here, of course, you can see the ingredients you need to make some salt dough. Salt dough is a really useful material because it's cheap, you can reuse it, probably better than you can reuse clay. And the way I use it is I always start any clay work with salt dough first so they can have a practice, and then once they've practiced, you give them the clay and they can make their final piece. So this is what you need. It says it here: 1 cup of flour, 1/2 cup of salt, 1 cup of water, tablespoonful of oil, just normal vegetable oil, and then cream of tartar, which you can get in most supermarkets. You only need a pinch of this, so you don't need loads. These are in sachets, but you can get big tubs of it as well. So that's cream of tartar. Right, so I'm going to make some salt dough. It's dead easy to measure out, it's all in cups, you don't need scales. And obviously, what you're going to need to do is I do 1 cup's worth first, see how much you've got out of that, and then when you've perfected your salt dough technique, you just multiply it by however many you need. I'd normally make like a handful, a blob per pupil. So you'll end up needing to make quite a large piece of salt dough. All right, also you'll need something to mix it in, so I've got a bowl here. So here goes, 1 cup of flour in there, 1/2 cup of salt, like that, 1 cup of water. Now I'd normally do 1/2 cup, see how you get on, and then if you need to, add the other 1/2 cup afterwards. A tablespoon of oil, I'm kind of guessing this with a lid, that's about a tablespoon. And finally, 2 tablespoons of cream of tartar, which is probably about 1/2 of one of these packets. Alright, so I've got that mixture in there. Just to reiterate, have a cup of water ready, but add it bit by bit. I'd start with 1/2 cup. And then add more if you need to. 1/2 cup always feels like just about right for me. So then you need to start to work it around a little bit. I quite enjoy getting messy, but you will get it sticky all over your hands. Okay, this is looking like it's coming out all right. Right, now what you need to really make sure you do is get this to the right consistency. It's really important this becomes the correct consistency for your workshop. If it's too sticky, it'll end up all over the kids' hands. If it's too dry, it'll fall apart when you make stuff with it. So I would definitely, if I was you, I would definitely do this the night before. Practice it. Once you've got kind of a good idea of what you're doing, you could probably do a small one to test it out, test your ratios out, and then work on a much bigger batch. Right, so this is starting to look all right. Still a little bit sticky, so it's sticky to the touch at the moment, so that's not really what you want for a workshop, otherwise it'll end up all over everyone's hands. So I'm going to add a little bit more flour, keep working it. Now also, I found it really depends on the type of flour you got, the type of cream of tartar, even like the temperature, if it's winter or summer. So it's always best to do this with a little bit of time to spare, because it might not quite work the way it did last time. Right, so you should be able to see this is getting a lot less sticky. It's not sticking to my hand anymore. This is almost ready. Maybe a bit more flour. Right. I think. This is starting to look alright. A good way to sort of make sure it's okay is that it doesn't stick to the table, which is good. And will it roll into a ball? It's pretty good. And then finally, what I normally do to check it, if I can start to make it into a long sausage and it doesn't fall apart or drop onto the floor, it kind of holds its own weight, that's looking pretty good, okay? So that is a really good piece of salt dough, ready to be used in the workshop. You can, of course, pack it into a tray, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you could do like 30 of these, cling film them over, and then they're ready for the next morning. Okay, now I'm gonna show you a warm-up you can do with your class. This is kind of like a warm-up to use the salt dough, okay? And it's so that they can, through storytelling, remember some key skills they'll need to use later on when they're making their objects. So I have a script here, a little picture script that I'll email, that's going to be emailed to you anyway. And it's the story of William, as in William Shakespeare's, birthday morning. And it's got skills hidden inside. So I'm going to go through it full pace, and then I'll break it down a little bit afterwards, okay? So, one morning, William woke up. On his bed, he found a beautiful, round, smooth football. "Happy birthday," shouted his mum. "What would you like for breakfast?" "Oh, I would like," said William, "a bowl of cereal." But he was still hungry. He wanted two more things. So you use a tool, chop it in half. He decided he would like a big, fat, juicy sausage and a lovely, flat, round burger. But just then, a snake came in through the window. The snake had scary eyes and a beautiful pattern running down its body. The snake coiled itself around the top of the burger. And William shouted to his mum, "I can't find my burger anymore, mum." She said, "Have a look in the fruit basket." The big, tall, strong fruit basket. Couldn't see any burger. "Don't worry, mum. I'm going to go and play with my beautiful, round, smooth football." And that's the end of the warm-up story. Now, a few little things for you to just think about as you use this. These are all key skills. So rolling the ball is a key skill. Making a thumb pot, that's the ball. Okay, pretty simple. Using a cutting tool. Now, what I've done here, this is just a lollipop stick cut with scissors, okay? That's a really simple cutting tool. Of course, you might have some clay tools in your school, so cutting things in half is a useful skill, getting used to using tools. Rolling a sausage, useful shape. A flat burger really is a slab, that's what you call a slab. And another useful skill is, of course, if you've got the burger, which is the flat slab, and you've got a snake, which is actually what you would call a coil. What this becomes, or can become, is a coil pot. Okay, so that's how you make a coil pot. And of course, that could be with a clay tool, could be decorated, could be embellished. Okay. So from this storytelling and this little warm-up, you can then move on to actually show them how to make things from the Shakespeare plays. Just a quick note, if you don't want to do this, that's fine, but I would have the pupils as a warm-up just working this in their hands. They can just, you can ask them just to roll a ball, to roll a sausage, to break it in half, have two balls. They can make a thumb pot out of this one, which is very, very easy. They can make a lid out of this one by making a burger. Okay, so just have them sort of play around with it and get used to it before you start to make your Shakespeare things. All right, so that's how you can get warmed up. Okay, so I'm going to show you how to make a donkey head for Midsummer Night's Dream. This is really, really simple, but very, very effective. Right, first thing you need to do, get the pupils to break this into three equal parts. Okay, three equal parts and roll these into balls. This is how you're going to start making the donkey head. Then make one of these into a burger. So you just do that by flattening it out. Really simple. Okay, first thing. Next thing to do, you're going to make this one into a fat sausage. Fat sausage, not a big long thin one, a fat sausage, okay? And if they're trying to measure things against you, it just shouldn't be longer than the burger. All right, like that. Then what they need to do is kind of pinch this bit thinner, like so. Okay, now that goes on there. And that's going to be pressed down a little bit, kind of squished into place. All right. Then this turns into what will become the ears. So these need to be half and half, okay? And these are, again, rolled into sausages, like this. And they're put on here. And you can kind of squish this down. This won't attach really, okay? This doesn't become a very solid thing. It needs to be resting on a table. And these are going to be the ear shapes. So you can start to sort of shape them into ears. And again, using a tool, these are the cheapest sort of tools to do. Press those down like that, and you'll start to form these kind of like ear shapes. Okay, so that's the start of the ears. Then, start to put the eyes in. Now, donkey eyes are actually quite far apart. Here and here. So there are the eyes. So the donkey eyes goes. Nostrils go here. And again, quite far apart, downwards like that, and then the mouth is there. All right, so you've got a mouth that you can kind of open up a little bit, nostrils, the eyes, you might want to kind of wiggle open a little bit. So that's your basic donkey head. What you need to start to do now is kind of shape these a little bit. Maybe this one folds over a little bit like this. You can start, the pupils now can start to add character to their donkey, okay? This mouth might open a bit more, like that. And, of course, with your tool, start to give it some character. So I would start to try and do the hairs . Okay, so that I think is a pretty decent little donkey that doesn't take very, very long. Now, just to show you, these don't really work without support. They have to be held, okay? But a lovely way to get photographs is to get photographs of pupils holding their work like this. I think it's a really beautiful way for them to show that how delicate these pieces of work are. So these are just so they can start to think about the actual character of this donkey, you know? Can add textures in those as well. All right, I'm pretty happy with that. So that's the first one. That is the donkey for Midsummer's Night's Dream. All right, this bit is going to be for Macbeth, or the Scottish play. And this is for the witch face, okay? So what you're going to need to do is start with a big blob. Divide it into two, like that. This one is going to be made into a flat burger. This is the base of your face. Then you need to try and shape it a little bit so it's kind of long, like this. All right, so it's kind of face shaped. You might have pupils looking at each other and looking at the shape of their face and trying to model it a little bit. All right, then with this bit, you've got all the features you can add. So obviously, you want to be adding a nose. Sausage, pinch it at the end, stick it on. Here comes the witchy nose. Two little balls, make the nostril bits. Okay, so we started to get a nose going. Now eyes go in, you don't have eyes sticking out. So the best way to do eyes is to push in like that. Okay, you push in first, and then from there you can kind of build eyebrows, stuff like that. And again, really, mouths go in. Don't build them out, they go in. There we go, I've wiggled that out. Once you've got the mouth, of course, you can add like a jagged tooth or something. Eyeballs now can sit in the hole that you've made. Of course, you're going to want warts because it's a witch. Nostrils up here. Now you've got a bit left, so this is where they can get creative. They might want to start to add a hat. This is going to be the witch's hat. They might want to start to do hair. Hair takes a long time if you're going to be really, really, really kind of like finickety about it. But here's some hair, straggly hair. Okay. And this is how you can begin to start to do your witch's face. Now, of course, this is great for character descriptions because you can really, really work into this, how each individual kid is going to actually describe the witch's face. Maybe we have some hairs coming off the moles. Maybe we have some wrinkles around the eye. Maybe a few dimples. Alright, so there you've got a witch's face for Macbeth. Right, so this last one is going to be for Romeo and Juliet, and it's going to be the kind of objects, opulent objects you'd find at the ball, at the big do, okay? Which they can relate to kind of their contemporary lives. And again, I would have them maybe make two objects. So break it in two. One object could be kind of like a goblet or a cup or something they're going to actually have their wine in. So an easy way to do that is to do a thumb pot. Push your thumb in the middle. So this is the cereal bowl from the start of the story. And then work it up into a shape. Like this. Maybe add some handles. See, the problem is, yeah, okay, there you go. And then, of course, you can start to add the detail, make it look really, really cool. So I'm going to do a little pattern. I'm going to do this. I might do down here, some patterns going around. Maybe this one belongs to Juliet, so it's got a J in it there, okay? So they can make objects that you'd find at the ball. So there's a nice little drinking goblet. You could also do goblets that look a bit more like this. So a flat burger, a bit like that, a bit like this. And then instead they're gonna kind of work on a flat, slightly 3D'd goblet like this. Alright, so this again, they can add all their designs to it. So they can have their dots going around. They could have kind of like, it's like this. Maybe this has got lots of different designs happening here. And what you could actually do as well, again, is do a tableau, which is a flat kind of artwork of all the things you'd find at the ball. So maybe jewellery, maybe there was gifts. Maybe you've got jewellery there, so you've got some necklaces. I'm sure you get the idea of this, guys. You just carry on doing this to make a necklace. Some necklace bits. Maybe they're gifts, maybe they're crackers. Or presents, or all sorts of things. So you can basically work on a set of objects again that kind of show the opulence and the different things you get. Goblets, necklaces, brooches. Oh yeah, you could make a brooch. So you could kind of do a brooch with maybe, I mean, this would be quite good to do. Maybe you do a brooch or a crest of arms. So you try and design something. That's kind of got that crest of arms kind of shape to it. And maybe you have like M for Montague. And maybe like, I don't know, a bit down the middle. And a C for the other guys, and of course they can design this so it's like a crest of arms or a brooch. So you can basically make kind of like artifacts and things that you'd find at the ball. Just remember that these won't become props. You can't really have these as props because they kind of flop around a little bit. Alright, so that's the video for how you can make things for the Romeo and Juliet ball. Okay, so this little bit is going to be for the Tempest, and they're going to make an island scene. So the scene of the island, the sort of wild island with trees and birds and stuff. And what each person will need to do with their blob of salt dough, break it into four bits, like this. And each bit is going to become a different aspect of an island. So you'll be working maybe in groups of four or five. So each pupil in that group of five will make four things each. You can end up with 20 different objects that they can put together to make an island, like an island tableau. For example, trees. They can start to roll some snakes, start to make some trees. Palm trees are easy. Just do them like this. And again, using the simplest of tools, or if you're lucky, you might have some proper clay tools. You can start to use these to kind of like make these into leaf shapes. Okay, so you might have palm trees, you might have animals, so maybe they're going to try and make birds, fantastical birds, I don't know. And again, they should have these skills. They should be able to roll a ball, they should be able to make another little sausage for the bird's tail, maybe a little one for the head, like that, a little bit for the beak, legs. And again, you're making this as like a, these legs aren't very good. You're making this as a kind of flat tableau. It's not a 3D stood up thing. It's all flat on the table. because with salt dough, it's not got the strength to stand up. It's going to be flat. Okay, so you've got a little bird, and again, you can use the tools to add bits of detail to this. There's its wing. Maybe make this a bit more extravagant. Not quite sure about these feet, to be honest, but hey, this is how a kid might work. So there's a bird, mountains in the background. Maybe this is a volcano, so we're going to have some smoke coming out of it. So they can very quickly start to build as a team these kind of different scenes, adding little bits of detail. That's the mountains in the background. Maybe some more scenery here, maybe some plants that are growing. Okay, so I hope you kind of get the idea. It's a really, really nice way for them to build and kind of think as a team, start to get these to look like. Plants as well. This might be a bit more 3D. There might be fruit, so maybe this becomes a banana tree. Make some little bananas. There's a banana hanging from the tree. There's a banana. So obviously it's all these like fantastical elements that you'd find on this amazing island. So they can let their imagination run wild. Maybe, of course, a little snake. Okay, so hopefully that makes sense. That's how they'd start to build their Tempest scene. And then of course, other pupils would add their pieces here and here, and there'd be birds in the sky. And that would be how you build your Tempest scene. All right, this bit is gonna be for Macbeth, or the Scottish play. And this is for the witch face, okay? So what you're gonna need to do is start with a big blob. Divide it into two, like that. This one is going to be made into a flat burger. This is the base of your face. Then you need to try and shape it a little bit so it's kind of long, like this. All right, so it's kind of face shaped. You might have pupils looking at each other and looking at the shape of their face and trying to model it a little bit. All right, then with this bit, you've got all the features you can add. So obviously, you want to be adding a nose, sausage, pinch it at the end, stick it on. Here comes the witchy nose. Two little balls, make the nostril bits. Okay, so we started to get a nose going. Now eyes go in, you don't have eyes sticking out. So the best way to do eyes is to push in like that. Okay, you push in first. And then from there, you can kind of build eyebrows, stuff like that. And again, really, mouths go in. Don't build them out, they go in. So there we go, I'll just wiggle that out. Once you've got the mouth, of course, you can add like a jagged tooth or something. Eyeballs now can sit in the hole you've made. Of course you're going to want warts because it's a witch. Nostrils up here. Now you've got a bit left, so this is where they can get creative. They might want to start to add a hat. This is going to be the witch's hat. They might want to start to do hair. fair takes a long time if you're going to be really, really, really kind of like finickety about it. But here's some hair, straggly hair. Okay, and this is how you can begin to start to do your witch's face. Now, of course, this is great for character descriptions because you can really, really work into this, how each individual kid is going to actually describe the witch's face. Maybe we have some hairs coming off the moles. Maybe we have some wrinkles around the eye. Maybe a few dimples. Alright, so there you've got a witch's face for Macbeth. Right, so this last one is going to be for Romeo and Juliet, and it's going to be the kind of objects, opulent objects you'd find at the ball, at the big do, okay? Which they can relate to kind of their contemporary lives. And again, I would have them maybe make two objects. So break it in two. One object could be kind of like a goblet or a cup or something they're going to actually have their wine in. So an easy way to do that is to do a thumb pot. Push your thumb in the middle. So this is the cereal bowl from the start of story. And then work it up into a shape. Like this. Maybe add some handles. See, the problem is, yeah, okay, there you go. And then, of course, you can start to add the detail, make it look really, really cool. So I'm gonna do a little pattern. I'm gonna do this. I might do down here, some patterns going around. Maybe this one belongs to Juliet, so it's got a J in it there, okay? So they can make objects that you'd find at the ball. So there's a nice little drinking goblet. You could also do goblets that look a bit more like this. So a flat burger, a bit like that, a bit like this. And then instead they're going to kind of work on a flat, slightly 3D'd goblet like this. Alright, so this again, they can add all their designs to it. So they can have their dots going around. They could have kind of like bits like this. Maybe this has got lots of different designs happening here. And what you could actually do as well, again, is do a tableau, which is a flat kind of artwork of all the things you'd find at the ball. So maybe jewellery, maybe there was gifts, maybe you've got jewellery there, so you've got some necklaces. I'm sure you get the idea of this, guys, you just carry on doing this to make a necklace. Some necklace bits. Maybe they're gifts, maybe they're crackers, or presents, all sorts of things. So you can basically work on a set of objects again that kind of show the opulence and the different things you get. Goblets, necklaces, brooches. Oh yeah, you can make a brooch. So you could kind of do a brooch with maybe, I mean, this would be quite good to do. Maybe you do a brooch or a crest of arms. So you try and design something that's kind of got that crest of arms kind of shape to it. And maybe you have like M for Montague. And maybe like, I don't know, and a C for D. the other guys, and of course they can design this so it's like a crest of arms or a brooch. So you could basically make kind of like artifacts and things that you'd find at the ball. Just remember that these won't become props. You can't really have these as props because they kind of flop around a little bit. All right, so that's the video for how you can make things for the Romeo and Juliet ball.